What's going on, guys? It's the Cowboy here. You guys know how it goes, that this video is gonna be epic. 'Cause I'm a cowboy! Oh, man!
And now, your mama knows!
Guys, this is a little more of a serious tone video, and there's people who would believe once the cowboy got a PS5, once the cowboy stopped primarily supporting Stadia, that's the reason why Stadia died. And that's crazy to think. So we're not even going to get into rumors like that. But what we are going to get into is this. Have you ever been the underdog in life? Or have you ever liked something that was the underdog? Have you ever had a sports team that you liked and that sports team just was never doing enough to where you felt they were gonna win? It's like every time that sports team was doing something great, somebody had something to say. They was never good enough. Oh, they got to this goal, but you know what? They didn't get this many yards. Like, have you ever had that in life too? It was so frustrating. You just said, you know what? If my team was in the playoffs, I just can't wait till my team lose and get out the playoff. Because you know what? I'll be done. You know what? Let's do it.
Subscribe to the most epic channel on YouTube for live streams every week, daily videos. Subscribe!
Now, I know a bunch of people might not like where I'm going, but I gotta keep it real. Listen, me personally, I was one of the most diehard Stadia fans. You ask anyone if you never heard of me, aka the Cowboy. Some call me the Stadia Cowboy. All right, my channel obviously is Now Your Mama Knows, and I was behind the Stadia Bash Community Network along with my guy Spectre. Okay, we came up with it, so we put so much work and help building the Stadia community, and along with the other pillars of the community, and then along with other new people in the community. But I'm gonna tell you something, guys. I remember just first getting into Stadia, and all my friends, people I know from high school and from, you know, when I was a kid, right? People I know off the internet, and they bashed Stadia, and they went on and on, it's not gonna work, it needs internet all the time, what would you do if your internet go down, blah, blah, blah. And guys, it really got old and tiresome, to the point where we kind of beefed, and I left our chat. I was like, forget those guys. I'm going to go on and do my own thing. I met all these new people on the internet. They understand me. They get me, right? And it didn't stop there because it was always somebody else. Stadia's going to die. Stadia don't got this game. Stadia don't do this. Stadia don't do that. They got no surface bar. Like, the on and on list of what Stadia can't do and they're too late and they don't have, it's just a lot. And so me personally, it was a little bit of stress off my back when I got a PlayStation 5. Because I knew eventually I would be dabbing in a different ecosystem. And I knew that I had broke my mentality of saying Stadia is my only ecosystem. Because truth be told, when I was a Stadian, when I was a Stadia stan, when I was a Stadia fanboy, whatever comments or names you want to call me, it was rough. So I feel bad for my fellow content creators that's die-hard Stadians, that's all they did, that they had Stadia in the name of their content creation. I feel bad for you because you didn't make a switch. But for me, I'm going to say I'm lucky because my channel is a Now Your Mama Knows. My biggest video is about an Ethernet cable, 70-something thousand views. My second biggest video is about a treadmill. 50 something thousand views. So for me in gaming, yeah, I was really grounded to Stadia, but I knew that didn't dictate my channel. So once I got a PlayStation 5, I knew that someday I would start doing more content, and I'm glad that I am doing more content. I loved Marvel Avengers. I created the Stadia Avengers channel. I did Stadia Avenger Marvel Monday streams. But guys, I started playing it on PlayStation, and I'm happy that I started playing on PlayStation. Now, the foresight, I had no clue what was going to happen. But honestly, I'm actually glad that Stadia is dead, because it was getting tiresome to even go back and forth with my peers. I'm a gamer's gamer, and it was bothering me that Stadia couldn't get the games that I want. So loving the platform and knowing it's going to underperform for my personal gaming needs was very tiresome. And then having other people tell me, well, go play another game. Don't worry, that game may come one day. Just cross your fingers. That was very tiresome, saying to people, if I love a game, I shouldn't have to wait. I should just be able to go out and get it. If I love a game, you shouldn't tell me that if I want that specific game I love, that, hey, just play something else. Day in and day out, it was very tiresome to go back and forth with my peers that I helped build a community with. So me personally, it's over. All the anguish, all the heartaches, all the torments, guys, it's over. So personally, I think Stadia was having it rough. I didn't think they was going to end this. I always thought the end of 2023 would be their year. They would use low change porting and start to benefit with a bunch of AAAs and bigger titles that would get the platform more recognition. But honestly, I'm happy Stadia is dead. Because why drag it out? Let people who are content creators take this time to come up with new bright ideals and let their channel flourish. They already have a base of people who watch them. So now, guys, it's your chance to go back to the drawing board. But at least this time, you already have viewers that will follow you in your new journey. Because guess what? It's not like you said, hey, I'm no longer covering Stadia. I'm going to cover PlayStation 5. You might lose some people, right? As an example. No, the viewers already lost Stadia and you lost Stadia. So you guys could migrate together. When can a content creator move on and his player base or fan base or viewership lose the same thing and say, you know what, we're going to migrate with you together? Now, that's happened a couple times in my viewing, YouTube, right? I've watched the Friday the 13th guy have to start over. I've watched the Destiny creators have to come up with new stuff every time Destiny go up and down. I've watched Anthem content creators have to start over. Guys, it does happen. So it's no different than what's happening with the Stadia community. Because I believe we will rise up, we will move forward, and we will all get new things to do. And for the content creators that just hang their hat up totally, that's your right. And I know I'll miss you, and I know your viewership will miss you as well. But it's your right as a content creator to say you're done. So with that being said, guys, I just want to pour out my heart a little bit, and I wanted to be honest with you. I'm glad that Stadia is dead. We could all stop being dragged through the mud, wanting this platform to be great, and for whatever reason, Google wasn't on the same page. And that's nothing against Google, because they have to make billion-dollar decisions. That's fine. But for me, I got to do what the cowboy got to do. So as you know, my channel is a smorgasbord of entertainment. Guys, I got it all. So you'll still get gaming. You'll still get entertainment with non-gaming. You'll still get reviews. Guys, and if there's some other content creators that maybe they won't make content anymore, just come on over to Now Your Mama Knows. I got something for you. So thank you for listening. Thank you for all the support you guys have been doing in this trying time for all the Stadia fans, including myself. I appreciate it. And guys, together, we'll beat this whole thing. So with that said, I'm glad Stadia is dead. And now, your mama knows.
And now, your mama knows.